Florida voters are about to be handed a big decision in November. They'll have to decide whether they should get the final say on casino-style gambling.
Backers got enough petitions to put it on the ballot. It's called Amendment 3. NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias explains why it's a big deal.
Yeah, Kelly, it's a big deal because it would actually change the state constitution. Amendment 3 takes the power away from lawmakers in Tallahassee and gives it to voters. It also allows voters to make all future decisions when it comes to expanding gambling in Florida, something top lawmakers and voters seem to agree on.
We are known for our beaches and family trips to our beaches. We're known for our many amusement parks.
An image that Florida's top lawmaker wants to keep.
We have to protect that brand, and we can't have runaway gaming bills that are constantly before us in the legislature.
That's why House Speaker Richard Corcoran is supporting Amendment 3.
Any kind of change that would be an expansion of gaming from here to forward, if that constitutional amendment passes, would have to be voted on by the voters and get 60% of the vote.
Everything from more casinos to card games would be decided by voters.
The voters are the ones that are most educated, and they're the ones that are patronizing these establishments.
Patrick Prosperi builds gaming machines like these and doesn't trust lawmakers to decide gambling.
They're going with what the lobbyists want. Pretty much the lobbyists are going to want what whoever's paying them is going to want.
Sometimes it feels like that. I don't know if it's actually a truth, but it definitely feels like that.
Lee Goss among voters wanting a voice.
I think people should be able to be part of making up the rules.
And they'll get that say if 60% of voters approve Amendment 3 in November.
I think we should have the final say because it's a law that affects us and something that we can do in our everyday lives. So it's something that we should have the vote on.
Now, this amendment is backed by an odd mix of gambling and anti-gambling interests. Disney, against gambling, supports it and has given a lot of money to get it on the ballot. The Seminole Tribe also supports it. They chose not to talk with me today on camera about their reasons why. Live in the studio, Dave Elias, NBC2.